Good morning, students. Now let us proceed the chapter number 8, reproduction. Now last time we had already discussed the separately male reproductive system and female reproductive system. Now let us today continue. What happens if the egg is not fertilized? You know that every month one egg become mature and released from the ovary, and then through the fallopian tube, and if the sperm is there, then if fertilized by the sperm, then goes to uterus and then implant there, then zygote is formed and then embryo is developing. But sometimes, suppose if the egg is not fertilized, it lives about for one day, means 24 hours, it becomes only remains live and then get destroyed. Since the ovary release one egg every month, either from the left side or right side, and uterus also prepared itself every month for to receive the fertilized egg. So lining becomes thick and spongy, that is called uterine wall, and that is called endometrium, right? And this required the nourishing the embryo if fertilization had taken place. Now the lining is not needed any longer, no fertilization is there, then what happens? This lining slowly breaks and comes out through the vagina as blood and mucus. This cycle takes place roughly every month, means about 28 days, and is known as menstruation, that is also called periods, okay? And it lasts for 2 to 8 days every female, okay? Now let us discuss about the reproductive health. You know that when we grow at the age of about 18-20, the girl's age, so in our family there is a pressure, in our neighborhood, our relatives, that they pressurize to get married soon and have the children, and same time the pressure from government also, government agencies, they also pressurize to avoid having children. So in this situation, making choices can become very difficult, okay? So you have seen the process of sexual maturation, that is gradual, takes place while general body growth is still going on, and the sexual maturation does not necessarily mean that boy or the body or mind is ready for sexual acts or for having and bringing up children. How do we decide if the body or the mind is ready for the major responsibility? All of us are under many kinds of pressures, okay? So pressures, you know, from friends, from relatives, from parents, and from government also. Now we must also consider the possible health consequences of having sex. We have discussed in 9th standard about the diseases. They can be transmitted from one diseased person to one healthy person, that is the bacterial diseases like the syphilis and gonorrhea. Syphilis and gonorrhea, these two are bacterial infections. If someone is suffering from these diseases and having the sex with the healthy person, then this definitely this disease transmitted. And the bacterial diseases can be cured after some time. But the viral diseases like HIV, AIDS, 9th standard you learnt, okay, and WARS, these are two viral diseases and these are very difficult to prevent from it, and we have to prevent from it. And so how it is possible to prevent the transmission of these diseases during the sexual act? Now using a covering, that is called condom, and for the penis during the sex helps to prevent transmission of many of these infections to some extent. Now it has the always the potential to lead the pregnancy, and pregnancy will make major demands on body and mind of the woman. She is not ready, then her health will be adversely affected. Therefore, many ways have been advised to avoid the pregnancy, and contraceptive methods. These methods are condom for both male and female, covering the vagina and the penis. Then copper tea. Then some pills are advisable to take to imbalance this hormones. Then surgery for both male and female. So let us talk about these contraceptive methods. So this contraceptive methods, these are the mechanical barriers also called, then so that the sperm does not reach the egg. Condoms on penis or similar covering born in vagina can serve this purpose. And other is that is contraceptive act that changing the hormonal balance of the body so that the egg is not released and fertilization does not occur. These drugs commonly need to be taken orally as pills, like Maladi, okay? And since they change the hormonal balance, but these show some side effects too. So without doctor's advice, these pills should not be taken. Then other contraceptive device that is called loop or copper T are placed in the uterus to prevent the pregnancy. Again, they can cause side effects due to irritation of the uterus. If the vas deferens in the male is blocked, then sperm transfer will be prevented. If the fallopian tube in female is blocked, then egg will not be able to reach the uterus. In both the cases, the fertilization will not take place. Surgical methods can be used to create such blocks. While surgical methods are safe in long run, surgery itself can cause infections and other problems if not performed properly. Surgery can also be used for removal of unwanted pregnancies. These may be misused by people who do not want a particular child, as happens. These may be misused by the people who do not want a particular child, means girl. Illegal sex selective abortion of female fetuses. For healthy society, the male-female sex ratio must be maintained because of reckless female fetuside. Child sex ratio is declining at an alarming rate in some sections of our society. Although parental prenatal sex determination has been prohibited by law. Prenatal sex determination means बच्चे को पेट में ही check कराया जाए कि लड़का है कि लड़की है. So now it is India, it is prohibited. We have noted earlier that reproduction is the process by which organism increase their population. The rates of birth and death in the given population will determine its size. The size of human population is a cause for concern for many people. This is because an expanding population makes it harder to improve everybody's standard of living. However, if inequality in society is the main reason for poor standards of living for many people, the size of the population is relatively unimportant. If we look around us, what can we identify as the most important reason for poor living of standard, that is population increase? So government now forced to having two children only, hum do, hamare do, either one child, okay? Now we talk about the surgery. Here we the male surgery that is called vasectomy, and female surgery that is called tubectomy. Okay, so today we complete this chapter.